Hello everyone, in this video I will show you how to connect NetBeans 12.5, which is the latest version of NetBeans, to a MySQL database. So we will see how to connect to the MySQL database, then how to select a new database, and next we will see how to create a new table, then how to insert a row into a table, and how to modify a row, then how to delete a row, and finally how to execute an SQL statement. So the first thing that we need to do is to download the MySQL driver. So let's type MySQL. Now let's go to this link. Here we have just to click on this downloads link. Now we need to scroll down and to click on this link, MySQL Community Downloads. In this page we have just to click on this link, connector J for Java. Now in this page we have to select platform independent, then we can download one of these two files. So I prefer to download the zip file, so let's click on this download button. In this page I don't need to log in, so I will scroll down and I will click on this link, no thanks, just start my download. Now I need to save this zip file on my computer. So I will save it in documents and then I will create a new folder for this zip file that I will call jars. Now let's save it. Now let's open the folder that contains this zip file. So in this folder I have this zip file, so let's open it. And then let's open this folder. And I need to extract this jar file, so let's extract it. Now we can close this application and also we can close this folder. Now let's go to NetBeans. So here we can either click on services or we can go to window, then here we have just to click on services. So we obtain this explorer and here we have databases. So we can just expand it, and for the moment we did not create any connection to the database. So let's make a right click and let's click on new connection. So here as you can see we don't have the driver, so we need to add it. So let's click on this add button. Then we need to go to the folder where we extracted the jar file. So I extracted it on documents into a folder called the jars. Then I have to select this jar file. So let's click on open and let's click next. So in this window I have just to provide the server name, in my case it is on localhost, and this is the default port number. So I will connect to a database called MyShop. Also I will connect with the root user and of course I need to provide the password of this user. Now let's click next and then let's click next. So here I have to provide a name for this connection that I am creating. So I will remove all of this and I will call this connection MyShop on MySQL. Now let's click on finish. So this new connection has been created. I can expand it. And this is the database to which I am connected. So let's expand this. And if I expand tables, I can see that I have two tables inside this database. Also, if I scroll down here, I have other databases. So let's expand it. And here I can see the different databases that are available. So if I want to connect to this database, I have just to make a right click, then set as default catalog. Now I am connected to this database and I can expand it. And I can see the available tables into this database. For the moment I have only this table, but of course I want to connect to the MyShop database. So let's go to other databases and here let's select MyShop, then right click, then set as default catalog. So now I am connected to MyShop and what I need to do is to create a new table. So let's make a right click on tables, then create table. So here for this table I will call it products, and of course I need to add several columns, so let's click on add column. So for this first column, I will call it ID. It will be an integer, so I have just to select int. Then it will be a primary key, and it should be unique. So as you can see here, I don't have the ability to make this column auto increment, but this is not a problem. We will modify it later. Now let's click on OK. And now let's add a second column. So I will call it name. It will be a varchar. And it should not be null. Also, it should be unique. Now let's click on OK. And let's add another column. So I will call this column description. It is of type varchar. And the size is 255. So it can be null. Let's select this checkbox and let's click on OK. Now to create this table, I have just to click on OK. And this table has been created. So to see the content of this table, I have just to make a right click, then view data. Now in this area, I can provide the statement that I want to execute. And if I increase this area, I can see here the table that allows me to see the content of this table. So the first thing I want to do is to make the ID column as auto increment. So let's remove this. And let's create the statement that allows us to make the ID column as auto increment. Now to run this statement, I have just to click on this button. And the statement has been executed correctly. Now to add a new row into this table, I have just to close this page and to make a right click here, then view data. And if I increase the size of this area, I can click on this button that allows me to add a new row. Now in this window, I have just to provide the data of the row that I want to create. So for the name, I have to make double click. Then let's provide a name, for example, pen. For the description, I can say high quality products. Of course, we don't need to provide the ID because it is auto incremental. Now let's click on OK. And this row has been added. Let's add a new row. And let's add it. Now, if we want to modify, for example, the description of the first row, we have just to make double click. And here we can modify this description. And let's hit enter. Now to validate this modification, we have just to click on this button, commit record. And if we want to delete this second row, we have to select it. Then we click on this button, delete selected record. Now let's click on yes. And let's close this page and let's open it again. So to execute an SQL query, we can use this field. So let's remove this statement and let's add a statement that allows us to add a new row into this table. Now let's execute this statement using this button. And to see the data of this table, we have to make right click, then view data. And as we can see, this row has been added. Finally, thank you very much for watching and please subscribe to the channel.